EMT/paramedics of Reddit, what last words did you hear that will stick with you forever? Not a first responder, but an anesthesiologist. The ones that always stick with me are, when a patient is scared before a big case like a cardiac bypass surgery, and looking for reassurance, you tell them all you're going to take great care of them, and you do. Sometimes though, they never wake up, or come off the bypass pump despite your best efforts. Pretty depressing knowing their last words after decades of life are asking for reassurance and you tell them you'll do your best, only for your best, to not be good enough to top Mother Nature. This kind of reminds me of something an ex-girlfriend of mine said. She is an IQ nurse, and if they had patients that were to be induced and intubated, she would frequently have to talk to family about the seriousness of the situation. Attending family would often say things like, have to go and pick the kids up from school, see you when you wake up and the like. My ex would politely pull them aside and inform them that the reason their loved one was about to be put to sleep and hooked up to breathing machines was because medical staff thought their injury or illness might result in their death. The procedure itself can sometimes cause death, and perhaps the family should spend a little more time as it could be the last time they see them alive. So many family members had no concept of the term intensive care. Not EMT, but the last words from my dad, who was recovering from multiple heart attacks in a hospital in Atlanta. I was at work in Florida, were, it's really icy up here. Don't come up. I'll worry about you on the roads. I'll come down there to recover. Promise. I love you, buddy. Bye. I cold made it. He died 8 hours later. From a massive heart attack. I was 22. He was 56. I'm now 45. I miss the good years. The friend years. The adult years. Tell your parents you love them. Lots. Oh wow. I'm sorry. Just don't beat yourself up about how you didn't get there. You didn't know. And you were loved. My boyfriend is 25, and lost his dad at the start of this year, and when you said I missed the good years, the friend years, the adult years, I swear my soul broke a little more for him, and his younger brother. I'm sorry for your loss. Went through all the comments on this thread, this one made me cry instantly. I cannot tell you how sorry I'm for your loss. Be safe, my friend. No last words, and it's taking me a lot to write this. We responded to a car fire from a collision with a semi-truck. When we got there, I can still hear the passengers screaming. There is no worse feeling than knowing there's nothing you can do. It's also a sound I never want to hear again. This is the one that disturbs me the most out of all these answers. I was hanging out in my house one day, and heard a big crash outside, and saw a car that had flipped over. It was a Tesla and the doors had gotten stuck. I could tell that the people inside were trying to get out. At the time, I was only 11, so I had no idea what to do, but other people in the neighborhood had called 911 and run over to try to get the doors unstuck. Next thing I know, the car bursts out in flames with the people inside. The noise was horrible. I think I know exactly what you're talking about. The government needs to mandate that the car doors, hood, and trunk all need to open without electricity from the inside and out. The doors might've just been crushed, and then you can't open it from there. I love you. The spouse laid his hand on our patient's foot as we were locking the stretcher in place and said this. She died en route to the hospital. I hope if I'm on my deathbed, this is the last thing I can say to someone, anyone. What a beautiful thing for your last words. Every time I end a conversation with my mom, dad, relative, or girlfriend, I always end with I love you. I'm terrified of death, but knowing that my last words to them may be I love you gives me a bit more closure. Nobody wants to go, but if the last thing I can say, or have someone hear, is what they truly mean to me, it helps. I had to sit with a woman and her deceased husband, while she recounted her 56-year marriage to him. She loved him deeply, they had a great marriage, and she just kept asking what she was going to do now her best friend had gone. She would pat the side of his face, and give him the odd kiss, while she did this. It was both saddening, and an honor to have been present for this. Supposedly my uncle's last words were, when I wake up, somebody go get me. Fig Newton's died on the surgery table due to massive complications from pancreatic cancer. The surgery was only going to prolong the inevitable. When Rodney Dangerfield went in for his heart surgery and somebody asked how long he would be in the hospital, he said something like, "If it goes well, a couple days. If it doesn't go well, about an hour and a half." Unfortunately, it didn't go well. R.I.P. Rodney. He has my respect. In my head, I totally read that quote in his voice without even thinking about it. Jay Leno was there and has a story about that. Rodney was not able to move or talk, but his wife said he was still alert and could hear. She was telling Rodney, who was there to see him, and asked him to squeeze Jay's finger if he could hear. After Jay leaned in and said, "Rodney, that wasn't my finger," he kind of shook a little, and it felt good to make him laugh one last time. Relative told me about how they were in Iraq on patrol at Christmas, and how an IED trap blew up on a guy that bled out talking how he would never see his new baby's eyes. One of the guys from my high school was killed in Iraq by an IED. He had married his girlfriend before he left, and she had been pregnant for about 3 months or so before he was deployed. I imagine if he didn't die instantly, that's probably what he was thinking too. Dude, it's rough enough reading that, I can't imagine actually being there. It smells like burning hair and motor oil. I can't remember details like my surroundings or even the time. I just remember feeling like I got hit with a brick, crawling out of the gunner's hatch, while my LT had a panic attack screaming, "Roll over, roll over, roll over." Anytime my girlfriend tells her dog to roll over for a treat, all I can smell is burning hair. I would ask my GF to figure out a different command for rollover. EMT, second week on the job. Man in his 50s was in distress, some kind of cardiac event we thought. He just looked our paramedic in the eye, and like a small child said hello, and he slumped back on the gurney. It was the tone, the way he said it, that made it stick with me, like a 3-year-old who just spilled his juice. Can confirm, it's called a sense of impending doom, and it's seriously a thing. I've seen been told about tons of incidents where the patient turns to their doc medic nurse and says I'm going to die, and then does their damnest to see Jesus. I've seen it 4 times now, and it's always the same expression and tone of voice. Freaky. You can also get that sense if doom if you're given the wrong blood type. I hate it too. They have this look on their face, as though they can see through time and space. Not a paramedic, just first on the scene after a head-on collision. Car vs truck. Driver of the car was pinned in his vehicle, bleeding heavily from a broken femur bone, showing we were miles from the nearest town. The ambulance took 20 minutes to arrive. I held his hand the whole time, kneeling on the pavement, my pants soaking wet from his blood dripping out the bottom of the door. The whole time he kept saying, "My dog, is my dog okay? You have to help my dog." His dog, in the backseat, was by some miracle completely unhurt, just very scared. The guy lost consciousness shortly before the ambulance got there, and I then routed to the hospital. Please tell me you or someone took the dog. One of my biggest fears is that I'll die with no one to care for my pup. He was returned to the guy's family. This is one of my biggest fears also. 911 operator here. 2 weeks ago I had a lady give her address and just said clean up the body before the kids get home, and then hung up. She shot herself in the bathtub before help arrived. I can play it back in my brain like a recording. I have had at least half a dozen of these types of calls in an over 20 year career. I'm so sorry. Another dispatcher here, sending you love and wishes for sound sleep. Please take care of yourself. Thanks. I have been about it a long time. Talking about it, and even posting about it, helps me put it into context and cope. Pretty soon it will be in the little place where all the bad calls go, memories, but nothing that stops me from moving on to the next call. I feel like it shows her depression even more when she says the body. Not an EMT or paramedic. My dad was sick very often and always had hospital trips. He survived with 10% chance of living one time. But this last hospital trip 2013, he was in an induced coma. He had double pneumonia and numerous other things going on. My grandmother took me up there to visit him on my spring break. I was 15, and I would often just tell him jokes hoping that he could hear me. My grandmother decided to take a walk while I sat with him. He woke up out of a coma trying to rip the tube out of his mouth. I calmly said, "It's okay, Dad. Don't take that out. You're going to be okay. I love you." He just shook his head no with a tear rolling down his face. The nurse came in and put him back under. I was the last one to speak to my dad. That moment will stick with me forever. It wasn't my patient, but a fellow paramedics. He had a mid-30s age male who had injuries that didn't really give him much of a shot, even if he would have been in the OR when it happened. He looked at my friend and asked about the injuries. When my friend responded, he shrugged his shoulders and responded, "At least it's not raining." The man's optimism even in the face of death will never leave me. As far as myself, I haven't had anyone say anything profound, but I'm not sure the screams will ever go away. Wow, that will stick with me. Thanks for sharing. That's absolutely incredible. Thanks for sharing. I'm comforted that a dying man might have thought of young Frankenstein in his last minutes. What injuries would be that fatal, but leave you able to shrug and calmly chat? Not a paramedic, but my dad was, and he passed recently to kidney cancer. Not sure if they were his last words, but the last words I ever heard him say were in the hospice center when my grandmother, his mother, visited. At this point he was incredibly malnourished as he couldn't eat anything without immediately vomiting it back up. He spent most of his final days unconscious, sleeping, as he had basically zero energy. Before my grandmother left, she wanted to say goodbye. She has leg issues and can't walk by herself, so my uncle wheeled her over to him in her wheelchair and helped her stand up so she could give him a kiss. He woke up as she was standing over him and said, "Don't worry about me, I'm fine. I love you." Those were the last words I ever heard him say. He died 2 days later. I've posted in threads like these before, so I'll just copy one of my previous comments. His were, "I'm sorry you were here." Mine were, "I'm glad I'm here, brother. Keep talking to me." I responded as the lead EMT in the middle of a blizzard for a 35-year-old who had poisoned himself with strychnine. He detailed everything about why he did it, where the remaining supply was, so we wouldn't hurt ourselves trying to find it, and he even let me attempt to give him activated charcoal and start in forth 10 minutes on scene, and he began to seize and aspirated. I dropped an advanced airway and suctioned his airway until he went pulseless, and me and my partner did CPR for 16 minutes. Med control told us to cease, and that was it. This was 5 years ago, and that call still rattles around in my head.